when they start Horvat and Barzal, they don't always do that, although I think Patrick Waugh has done that a lot with Adam Pellick.
And right off the draw, it's Sanderson with some speed going to the net, put it across, grabbed by Barzal. The Islanders don't have the momentum up ice, so they will take it and bring it methodically ahead. Horvat to Barzal. Barzal now has Dobson with him as an option. Barzal finds an opening, tried to take a shot and surprise Korpisalo, makes the save and keeps it moving. Islanders getting caught in a change here, but the back check from Dobson got the puck away from Stützle, who then stole it away from Palmieri. Nelson having to hustle to get there.
Good job, and Brock knew the automatic out. Just get it over to Dobson. You get the sense there's going to be some chances in this overtime.
Palmieri leaned on, takes the seat, playing the puck. Tripped up Brady Tkachuk, who will get up and take the puck. Detroit has already won their game this afternoon against Buffalo, so if the Islanders want to stay in a playoff spot, they need this extra point. Shane Pinto leaves it for Brady Tkachuk, who's got two. Wrist shot in and out of the glove of Varlamov. Islanders calm things down for the moment. A minute 10 gone by here in OT.
Yeah, nice play by Palmieri. No pressure. Waited till everybody cleared out of the area. Ooh!
Pageau wasn't expecting that pass from Dobson.
No.
Be a turnover. Islanders just give up possession in overtime. As Matthew Joseph, who took that penalty that led to the Islander game tying goal, on the ice for Ottawa. It's Batherson with the puck. Batherson moving away from Holmstrom. Batherson has Varlamov scrambling. Dobson helps stop him from wrapping it around. And then Dobson plays it to Pageau. Bump back to Dobson, but he can't grab it. Varlamov will pop out and keep it under Islander control.
I need to slow it down. Holmstrom's way out by the blue line, and Dobson says, well, I'll just slow this thing down, and I imagine he might change.
Yeah, he's been on the ice for a minute and a half as Barzal carries in. Barzal, wrist shot, leaked through Korpisalo, but wide of the net.
Yeah, almost had him.
Now they have to hustle back. Well, Giroux stripped of the puck by Barzal, and the NHL leaders in takeaways.
Yeah, he's so quick, looking for a quick change, and puts Brock Nelson on the ice.
Nelson, Horvat, and Mike Riley as Claude Giroux.
There's what you don't like, Brendan, circling back.
Yep. Third straight overtime game for the Ottawa Senators, who have won one in overtime and one in a shootout in this stretch. As Tim Stützle works away from Horvat, drop past Chychrun. Nelson comes to challenge him. Now it's Giroux back to Chychrun in his skates. Halfway through overtime. Stützle taking it wide. And puck got stuck on his stick as he tried to drop it for Giroux. They find Giroux closing in, and it rolled off his stick.
Yeah, Riley was watching the puck and just got caught a little bit, puck staring.
Penalty taken here by Horvat. He got a little handsy with Stützle along the boards, and it'll be an overtime power play for Ottawa as the extra attacker coming on now as Korpisalo heads off. Stützle, poke checked away, and an Islander Horvat penalty for holding will set the stage here in overtime.
Take another look at that penalty, and yeah, you can't complain. You had a chance to tie the game late, and you did. And yeah, he's holding them. Look at the left arm. I think that's a good call, Brendan, watching it. And, I mean, you're not happy, and Horvat breaks the stick, so now you got to get a... Gave him a misconduct.
They give him an extra one, yeah. Horvat's going to be done here.
Yeah.
Oh, Horvat teed up by Kelly Sutherland for an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty after breaking the stick. And so they may have just given him a 10-minute misconduct, and he'll sit and watch from the box as Ottawa has called their timeout. They'll have a chance to win it here on an overtime power play.
I'm not sure why. Well, this Holmstrom came over, so must have brought him a stick. Horvat's got to be careful. He'll get thrown out of the game. I think he can still go in the shootout if they don't score in the power play.
Because of the misconduct, I don't think he can.
Well, no, if he gets a misconduct.
But yeah, he got 10, I'm assuming.
2 minutes.
There's the new stick given to him. And may have been the extra words after he was given the new stick that got him the extra penalty.
If he had 10, then he should be leaving the penalty box.
Well, if he had 2, he should be leaving the penalty box.
Yeah.
Face-off win for Ottawa. 4-on-3 on the power play. Islanders penalty kill in desperate need of one here. This one is out of play off a stick.
Oh, that's too bad, because that play would have been out of bounds. He would have had a chance to clear that puck.
Ryan Pulock, ready to chuck a few words. Lomov talking things over with Brandon Blandina. Before they put this puck down, Pelech, Pulak, and Pageau in charge of killing it off. At least the start of it. Tkachuk with Batherson, Giroux, and Stützle, four forwards for the Senators' power play. Tied up off the draw. Tkachuk able to get back to his feet. Puck was still there. Shoving after Pelech. Pelech stumbles down. Pageau tried to pin it here. Pageau pulls away with it. Takes his time and sends it down.
Good job, hard work along the boards there by the Islanders. Pageau and Pulak. So Cizikas comes out. Still plenty of time for the Senators on this 4-on-3.
Here's Tkachuk. He'll leave it for Batherson. Minute 13 to go. Claude Giroux. Drop past Stützle. Returns to Giroux. Stützle again. Over for Batherson. Save Varlamov. Pulak found the rebound and clears.
Nice job there. You know that Varlamov's reading that play. They're going to try and go wide on him. Nobody's going to shoot much if they're forward. Pageau Cizikas is standing right in front of the slot area.
45 seconds to go. 3-3 here in overtime. Giroux down. Tkachuk fumbled the puck. Pelech quickly on it. Gets to it and fires. The length of the ice. 35 seconds left. Islanders trying to send the game to a shootout. Ottawa trying to win it right here. Pelech falls down. That allows Pinto a little room. Pinto. Tkachuk. Game winner on the hat trick from Brady Tkachuk. Adam Pelech fell down in the neutral zone. That turned it into a 2-on-1 for Ottawa. They cash in and win it 4-3 with a power play goal in overtime.
Yeah, that was just a bad break there as Adam just tripped over the blue line, and the Ottawa Senators take advantage of that. Beautiful pass by Pinto quickly all the way across to Tkachuk, and he rifled it in a hurry, got that puck off his stick rather quickly. Three goals for Tkachuk.
Third career hat trick, second this season as he hits the 30-goal mark here this afternoon on Long Island with an overtime game winner that sends the Islanders losing streak to 3.
Now you watch the middle of your screen as Adam just trips over it. Ryan Pulak's trying to a little direction. See where Ryan Pulak put his stick there, Brendan? I don't know why he turned it to his left. He's got to protect the pass. And you can watch this. If you see this again, what happens is Ryan's got to keep his stick on the right side, prevent the pass. Watch him move it to the left. And that gave the opening for Tkachuk. So for me, Ryan would have been better served to keep that stick on the right-hand side instead of opening it up, forcing him to shoot the puck.
You know, he's pointing over to his right. I think he's saying Cizikas cut off that pass, but he wasn't there to cut off that pass.
No, he wasn't. And so that's, for me, it's a little bit of a mistake and a piece, obviously, of bad luck on Adam falling.